Now we're going to talk about how to use hammer-ons and pull-offs. First, a hammer-on. A hammer-on is when the first note is plucked and the second note, which is higher in pitch, is played by fretting or hammering onto that note. I'll show you what I mean. What I did was I picked the D string open, and then the second note, which was the second fret of the D string, I achieved that note by simply pressing down or hammering onto the second fret. I did not pick the second note. I only picked one time. How's that for a visual demonstration? Taking that right arm away from the strings. Okay, so that's a hammer-on. And we want to strive for those two notes to be the same volume. We should be able to control how loud each of the notes are, but a good test is if you can get that second note to be the same volume as the first note. So you may have to really push down hard on the strings to get that effect. Now the opposite of a hammer-on is a pull-off. That's where the second note is lower in pitch, and we achieve that second note not by picking, but by simply pulling or dragging off of the string. Take my hand off. That's a pull-off. And if we do a hammer-on followed by a pull-off, we get something like this. And if we continuously hammer on and pull off, that's known as a trill. Now let's try that without an open string. So let's hammer on 5 to 7 on the A string. And let's pull off 7 to 5 on the A string. I think a pull-off is a little more difficult. You have to kind of drag across that string to create enough force in order to hear that second pitch. If you just lift off, you may not get that note to be very loud. Okay, and if we continuously hammer on and pull off, we get a trill. So let's try a few licks. Here's the first one. This is a lick that would work great in the key of E. I'm going to hammer on and pull off, open E string to the third fret of the E string, back to the open E string. So that was a hammer on, pull off. Following this, we'll play on the third fret of the B string. We'll do those four notes 3 times. And then play the open E string once. So there's the lick. So that was a short lick using hammer-ons and pull-offs. Let's try a longer lick using all 6 strings. It'll sound like this. So I'll hammer-on and pull-off on the high E string, open to the third fret, back to the open string. 3rd fret B to the open high E. Now pull off 3 to the open B, followed by 2 on the G string. So far we've done this. Now I'll hammer on and pull off on the B string, open 3rd fret to the open string. 2nd fret on the G string. open B, pull off second fret to the open G, followed by the second fret of the D string. So that section. Put all that together, here's what we've done from the top. Continuing on, here's the next piece of this lick. Hammer on, open G string to the second fret of the G, and then pull off to the open G string. Second fret D, open G, second fret pulling off to the open D string, followed by the second fret of the A string. And this whole lick will end like this. A string, hammer on from the open string to the second fret, pull off to the open string. Last two notes, pull off from the third fret of the low E to the open low E. And here's the whole lick. One, two, three, four. All right, well, there are some hammer-ons and pull-offs. Great technique to incorporate into your playing.